Good morning, students. Now start the last exercise of chapter Linear Question to Variable, the optional exercise. Though it is given that this exercise is not for the examination point of view, but from this exercise, one question was there in the board exams few years ago. So definitely we will do this exercise. The first question of exercise is the age of Ani and Biju differ by 3 years. So we don't know which one who is bigger, either Ani or Biju. So let's take the present age of Ani is equal to x and the present age of Biju is equal to y. Since we don't know which one is greater, so we have to make the two equations for this statement. If Ani is bigger than Biju, then we will say x minus y is equal to 3. This is the one equation. Or this equation can be like this, that can be Biju can be bigger than the Ani. So it can be possible that y minus x is equal to 3. So both the equations are correct and we have to solve the equations, both the equations with the other equation. Like the other one is Ani father Dharm is twice as old as Ani. So present age of Dharm is equal to 2x according to question. It is given the question that Dharm, the father of Ani, having the age twice that of the Ani. So it means the present age of Dharm is 2x. And next one is, and Biju is twice as old as his sister Kathy. So it means Biju is twice as old as his sister Kathy. So it means the Kathy should have the age half of Biju. So we will see the present age of Kathy is equal to y upon 2. We know that y is twice then y upon 2. So if the age of Biju is y, so the age of Kathy will be y upon 2. Now the age of Kathy and Dharm differ by 30 years. So the age of Kathy and Dharm is differ by 30 years. It means it's obviously Dharm, the age of Dharm will be greater than Kathy. So we will say 2x minus y upon 2 is equal to 30. According to second equation, according to second statement, Dharm is twice as old as Ani and Kathy is half of the age of Biju. Or we will say the Biju is twice the age of Kathy. So the age of Kathy will be y upon 2. Now the difference of their ages is 30 years. So we will say 2x minus y upon 2 is equal to 30. This is the equation third. Now most important thing is you have to solve this equation with both these equations. Like by this one, you will solve this equation with this equation and also with this one. It means we will have two different answers. So these are the equation. Now we are solving this equation third with equation one. So by using the addition method, you know that what you have to do. First of all, remove the denominator, remove the fraction. You know the method of removing the fraction. Take the LCM and then take this denominator towards the RHS in multiplication. So it will be 4x minus y is equal to 60. Is it clear? We take the LCM of these terms. The LCM is 2. So you multiply it by 2. 2 is a 4x minus y upon 2. Now we take this 2 in multiplication with 30 towards the RHS. So we can say this is the third equation. Okay, we can write it like this is the third equation. Now you will solve this equation with both these equations. Okay, so first I am going to solve this equation with first equation. That is x minus y is equal to 3. Now I explained to you that if both, you know that you can cancel y, but what is the problem here? Both them have a same sign. So how can we change their sign? By separating these equations. So by separating the equation, we say in subtraction we have to change the sign. So it is 3x. Oh, space is not there. 3x is equal to 60 minus 3 will be 57. Then what is value x here? 57 upon 3 is equal to 21 and 9. Yes, x is equal to 19 years. And if we put this value of x in the equation 1, we can easily find the value of y. So I am going to put the value of x here in equation first. 19 minus y is equal to 3. You can write from equation 1. It is, we take this one from the equation 1. Now put the value of x here. Then y is equal to 3 minus 19. Then what should be the value of y? It is plus 16. Minus will cancel out with minus. Then y is equal to 16. Now this is not the complete answer. Now you will write the age of Ani is 19 years. The age of Biju is 16 years. So it's important that you have to write the units with the values. Now this is the one part. Now you will solve this same equation with this second one. Because we don't know which one is bigger, either Ani or Biju. So we have to take the both conditions. Either if Ani is bigger, then equation will be this. Or if Biju is bigger, this equation will be like this. So now we will solve this equation, equation third, with this equation second. So I have to rub the board because I have a very less space here. So I'm going to rub it. You can pause video for writing answer. Now I'm going to solve this equation third, that is 4x minus y is equal to 60. This is the equation second. I'm going to solve it with equation second, that is y minus x is equal to 3. Here the Biju is bigger than the Ani. This is equation second. Now how can we solve it? By adding the equation. Since both y have the same coefficients and having the opposite sign, so we can easily add the equation for cancelling the values of y. So this cancel out and we get 3x is equal to 63. Then what is the value of x is equal to? 63 upon 3, it will be 21. Okay. Now we will put this value of x here in this equation, that is equation second, y minus x is equal to 3. And we put the value of x here, that is y minus 21 is equal to 3. Then y is equal to 24. So in the second case, where Biju is bigger than Ani, we will say that the age of Ani is 21 years and the age of Biju is 24 years. So we have two answers because of these two equations, because it is not clear the question which one is bigger. So this was the question first. Now I'm going to explain you the second question. For writing answer, you know that you have to pause your video. Now the second question, it's a really easy question. Second question is, once they give me 100, friend, I shall be becomes twice as rich as you. And other reply, if you give me 10, I shall be 6 times as rich as you. Tell me, what is the amount of their capitals? So there are two friends. So I am writing the friends like A and B. Just try to understand it. Then I will explain the whole the parts and how will you write the question. Let two friends A and B. And the capital A has X and the capital B has Y. So okay, side by side we can write the statement. Let one friend has capital is equal to X. So the amount one friend has X. And the amount other friend will have is equal to Y. Okay, so these are the two friends having the amount X and Y. So one say the other, that give me 10, give me 100, okay, sorry, give me 100, I shall then become twice as rich as you. So if this B, the second friend, give the first friend 100 rupees, then it will have X plus 100, the amount, now the amount first friend will have X plus 100. And the amount the second will have Y minus 100, because he give 100 from this, from his capital to the other friend. Okay, this is not in rupees. So, okay, we can't say that rupees. So, the 100 number, the 100 amount, the 100 capital, B give to A. So, the A will increase his capital by 100 and B will decrease his capital by 100. So, according to question, we can say that this amount is now become twice as rich as you. It means it is equal to twice of this amount. So according to question, if B give 100 to A, then this amount becomes twice as this amount. So for making them equal, they have to multiply this one by 2. Suppose like this is 200 and this one is 100. So I will say this amount is twice as this one. So how can you equal them? By multiplying it by 2. So this is the first equation. We can simplify this equation. Like it is 100 plus x plus 100 is equal to 2y minus 200. So equation can be x minus y is equal to minus 300. This is the first equation according to the first statement. Yes. Now the second statement is, second friend say, it means B say, if you give me 10, I shall be 6 times as rich as you. So B says, if you give me only 10, I will be 6 times. It means this A will lose his capital by 10 and his capital will increase by 10. So he says, if you give me 10, then I will be 6 times as rich as you. It means this amount is 6 times of this amount. So the second one, if you give me 10, I shall be 6 times as rich as you. So now you have to find how much capital A and B both have. So we can simplify this equation, that is 6x minus 60 is equal to y plus 10. So simply this equation will be 6x minus 5 na? Is equal to how much? It is 70. This is the equation second. And now you can solve the equation by any other method. The easiest method is the allocation method. So the first equation was x minus y is equal to minus 300. So okay, we know that both y have the same coefficients and having the same sign, so we have to separate the equation for making them side opposite. So it will be 5x is equal to 300 plus 70, it will be 370. Then x will be 5 7 is 35. 20, 5 4 20. It means the amount friend 1 half is 74. And the amount B will have, we can put this value in the end of the equation like this. So I am going to put the value of x here in the equation 1. X minus y is equal to minus 300. 74 minus y is equal to minus 300. So 74 will be there towards the RHS and sign will be changed. So y will become equal to 374. This was the amount having by the friend B. So we can also check our answer, either it is correct or not. Suppose the question was A say give me 100. If we add the 100 amount to this one, now we are going to check the question. We don't need to write this question in your notebook, but you should know how can we check our answers, either this is correct or not. So he says give me 100. So the amount A will have will be 174 and B will lose by 100 rupees. It means it will become 274. So okay. Then he says that I will be twice as rich as you. I think I done some mistake here. Let me check. X minus OO. It will be X minus 2Y. Okay. It means a mistake can be happened by anyone. So you should do questions very carefully. Now I'm going to, you know, so by checking our answer, we can find either we are correct or not. Yes. So it is x minus 2y is equal to minus 300. Then, okay. I have to rub it. Rub this question. So, we can, for solving this equation, we can multiply the equation second by 2. So, we are going to multiply this equation second by 2. It will be 12x minus 2y is equal to how much? It is 140. Now, we can cancel out these values. It will be 11x is equal to 440. So, x will be, it will be 40. So, value of x is 40. And now we can put this value in any of the equation, either 1 or 2. So I am going to put this value here in the equation 1, that is 40 minus 2y is equal to minus 300. Then minus 2y is equal to minus 340. Then y will be equal to 170. Now we can check our answers. So he says me, he says to, A say to B that give me 100. Now the amount A will have will be 140. And the amount V remain will be 70. So it's correct. He says that I will be twice as rich as you. And then B says give me 10 only. So after giving the 10 rupees, it will be 30 and it will have the 180. So he says then I will become 6 times. Okay, let me check. I will be 6 times as rich as you. So this amount is 6 times of this one. So we can check our answers by putting the values in the questions. So, okay, we will continue the question now. Question number 3. Question 3 is, a train covered a certain distance at a uniform speed. If the train would have been 10 km per hour faster, it would have taken 2 hours. In this type of questions where we have that if we increase the speed, the time will be taken, less time will be taken by the train. In these type of question, the simple method, the easy method to solve these questions is, let take the speed of the train, okay? So let the speed of the train, speed of train is equal to x. And the time taken by the train to cover the certain distance is equal to y. And the time taken by the train to cover the distance is equal to y. So if the speed of the train is x and the time taken by the train to cover the distance is y, then what should be the distance? According to formula, we know that distance is equal to speed multiplied by the time. So we will say that the total distance covered by the train will be equal to xy. Okay, speed multiplied by the time. So the question is, if we increase the speed of the train, so now we will write it like according to question. If we increase the speed of the speed of the train is x and increases by 10 km per hour. So it means what should be the new speed now? It will be x plus 10. And in question is, it will take 2 hours less. Now the time taken by the train to cover the same distance is y minus 2. Because initially the train was taking the time of y hours. Now the time taken by the train to cover the same distance is y minus 2. Now it is taking 2 hours less. So this is the new speed of the train and this is the time taken by the train to cover the distance. Now for finding the distance, we know that we have the same formula, speed multiplied by the time. What is the speed now? Now the speed is x plus 10. And what is the time taken by the train is? It is y minus 2. Again the distance covered by the train is speed multiplied by the time. And since the distance is not changes, so we can say this distance now is equal to the initial distance covered by the train, that is x5. So the easy method to solve these type of questions, in which we have in the question that let the by increasing the speed of the train, the time taken by the train is itne hours less, or by decreasing the speed of the train, then time increases by this one. So in these type of question, the easy method to do such type of question is taking the speed x and taking the time y, and the distance will be xy. Now you can solve the equation according to the question, according to the statement in the question. Like when increasing the speed, time taken by the train is 2 hours less. So we will say now for what should be the distance? Speed multiplied by the time. And this, since the distance has not changes, so we will say that this distance is equal to the initial distance. Now we can solve this equation by multiplying both the brackets. It will be xy minus 2x plus 10y minus 20 is equal to xy. Now this xy will cancel out with xy. Or if you don't like to write the initial value with the negative sign, you can change their sign. You can change its sign by either taking minus as a common or by multiplying all the equation by minus 1. So now since this equation is divisible by 2, so I am going to divide the equation by 2. And we can say that we are taking minus 2 as a common. So this is a method, how can you simplify your equation? Either you can take common, any value, if there is something common in whole the equation, you can take as a common. Like minus 2 is common in this part. And we don't need the first value negative, without having the negative sign. So I am taking minus 2 as a common. So now we know that if we are taking minus as a common, what should we have to do? We have to change the sign within the bracket. Like it will be minus 5y and plus 10 is equal to 0. So now this minus 2 will be there towards the RHS in the denominator of 0. It will become 0. So we have the equation now, x minus 5y is equal to minus 10. This is the first equation. Okay. So simply we solve the equation in our own method, with our own method. Now the second statement is, if the train were slower by 10 km per hour, it would have taken 3 hours more. If the train slowed down its speed, it means now what should be the speed of the train? It should be x minus 10. Now the speed of the train decreases. So the time taken by the train will obviously increases. So the time taken by the train is y plus 3. By decreasing the time by 10 km per hour, the time increases by 3 hours. It means now this is the speed and this is the time taken by the train to cover the same distance. Now the distance is equal to speed multiplied by the time. And since distance is not changes, so we will say it will be equal to the xy. And we can simplify this equation, xy plus 3x minus 10y minus 30 is equal to xy. Xy cancel out with xy. Equation is 3x minus 10y is equal to 30. This is the second equation. Now you can solve the equation by using the elimination method. This is the easiest method to solve any equation. So let's make y common, y same. So we have to multiply this equation 1 by 2. So convert this 5 into the 10. So we are going to multiply the equation 1 by 2. You will write the statement here by multiplying the equation 1 by 2. And by multiplying it, we will get 2x minus 10y is equal to minus 20. So again, you should multiply whole the equation by any number. Like 2x minus 10y is equal to minus 20. Now we can add the equation. Sorry, we have to separate the equation. Why we have to separate it? Because both the y having the same coefficient but having the same sign. And you want to make them, you want to cut them. Then it means you both should have the different opposite sign. Or for changing this sign, we have to separate the equation. So we are going to separate it. For separation, we have to change sign. Like this, x is equal to 50. So what is x? X is the speed of the train. And now the time, if you want to find the time, you can put the value of x in any of the equation, like in equation 1. X minus 5y is equal to minus 10. Equation 1. 50 minus 5y is equal to minus 10. It will be minus 5y is equal to minus 60. Then y is equal to 12. So this is the value of y. This is the value of x. It means the speed of the train is 50 km per hour. And the time taken by the train to cover the distance is 12 hours. Now finally what we have to find? We have to find the distance covered by the train. So formula, distance is equal to speed multiplied by the time. Speed is 50 and time is 12. It will be 600 km. Okay. So this is the question. This is the question number 3. Easy question. In such type of question, we take the speed x and time y and the distance xy. Now I am going to explain the next question. Question number 4. Again, you can pause video for writing answer. Are made to stand in a row. If 3 students are extra in a row, there would be 1 less row. In such type of questions in which you have the certain number of rows and there are certain number of students in one row. So for solving these questions, the easiest method is you can take the number of rows xx. Nice x. So let the number of rows is equal to x. Okay. And the student in each row, number of students in one row is equal to 1. Now suppose you have 10 rows, okay, you have 10 rows and in each row there are 8 students. Then how many students, total students will be there? It will be 8 multiplied by the 10, that is 80. So how you get this answer 80? By multiplying the number of students in one row by the number of rows. So In this part, now we have the number of rows x and the student in one row is y. So what is the total strength of the students and what is the total number of students are there? It will be x into y. Total students will be x, y. Okay, this is the total strength. Now what is the question? Three students are extra in a row. There would be one row less. Three students extra in a row. Now we know that the number of students in a row is y. And now we have three students extra in a row. Then there would be one row less. Now the number of rows is x minus y. Yearly the number of rows in the previous case the number of rows is x, and if we increase put some students from rows into the line, it means we are removing one or two rows and the students we are arranging in the same rows. Like आपने यहाँ से बच्चे हटाए और उधर को पहले जो rows है उसमें आपने बच्चों को डाल दिया. So by increasing the number of students in a one row, in a each row, the number of rows become decreases actually. So it means this is the number of rows now and these are the number of students in a one row. So what should be the number of total students? It will be again number of rows multiplied with the number of students in one row. Now we know that the strength of the students are not changes. So we can say this into this is equal to x, y. This is the total strength of the students. Now we can multiply the brackets. It will be xy plus 3x minus y minus 3 is equal to xy. Xy will cancel out with xy. We get the equation 3x minus y is equal to 3. This is equation 1. Okay. And then again, according to question, the question is if three students are less in a row. Now we remove some students from one row and we make the another rows. So in this question we have three students are less in a row. Now the number of students in a row are y minus 3. Initially it was y, but now we decrease the three students from one row. Three students are less in a row, there would be two row more. Now the number of rows is x plus 2. These are the number of rows and number of students are not changes, so we can say this one is equal to xy. Now we can solve the equation by multiplying the bracket. It will be xy minus 3x plus 2y is equal to, sorry, not is equal to, minus 6 is equal to xy. Xy will cancel out with xy. We get the equation minus 3x plus 2y is equal to 6. This is the second equation. Now you want to solve the equation by using the addition method. You can make the y coefficient equal by multiplying the equation 1 by 2. So I am going to multiply this equation by 2. So you will write here by multiplying the equation to equation 1 by 2. So 3 to the 6x minus 2y is equal to 3 to the 6. This is the equation third. Now since both the y have the positive sign, so we will add the equation. Cancel. We get 3x is equal to 12. Then x is equal to 4. We get the answer 4. What is the 4? 4 is actually the number of rows. And for finding the value of y, we can put the value of x in another equation. I am writing it here in the first equation. 3 into 4 minus y is equal to 3. This is equation 1. We put the value of x in the equation 1. So we get 12 minus y is equal to 3. And we get minus y is equal to minus 9. It means y is equal to 9. These are the number of students in one row. So if you want to find the total strength of the class, yes, you have to find the number of students in a class. So it will be x into y. It means 9 4 is 36. Total number of students in a class is, 4 multiplied by 9. It is 36 students. So this was the question number 4. Okay, I am going to explain you one more question. Question number 5. Then we will have only the 3 questions. 3 questions will be left here. After doing question number 5. Then you can try these questions yourself And in case of any doubt, you have your Zoom classes for your doubts. Question number 5. Fifth question is, angle C is equal to thrice of angle B, is equal to thrice of angle A plus angle B. Find the three angles in a triangle ABC. Suppose the angle A is equal to X, the value of angle A is equal to X, and the angle B is equal to Y. So, according to this relation, which we have angle C is equal to thrice of angle B, we can find angle C will be 3y, because angle C is equal to thrice of angle B. So, we get angle C is equal to 3y. Okay, in a triangle ABC, since ABC are the triangles, are the angles of a triangle, so we can say the sum of all the angle of a triangle will be 180. So, first equation is angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180, or we can say X plus Y plus 3y is equal to 180, X plus 4y is equal to 180. So this is the equation first, easy equation. Now this is the second relation. Now we will use this relation, thrice of angle B is equal to thrice of angle A plus angle B. So thrice of angle B is equal to thrice of angle A plus angle B. Now I'm going to put the value here, angle B is Y is equal to 2 X plus Y. Simply, I put the value of angle A and angle B. We get 3Y is equal to 2X plus 2Y. Okay, yes. So, it is, we can bring this 2Y here towards the LHS and its sign will be changed. So, Y is equal to 2X. This is the equation second. Now, it's in your hand how, what method will we use? You will use to solve this equation. Either you can use the addition method or the subtraction method. So again, in this question, I'm going to use the separation method. After doing a large number of questions, I'm going to explain another question by using the separation method. So I'm going to substitute the value of y in this equation, equation 1. So you will write here, by substituting the value of y from equation 2 into the equation 1. Okay? So writing these statements are very important. You will write the equations, you will write the statement before doing anything. So X minus plus 4 into Y. Okay, again you will write here by putting the value of Y from equation 2 into the equation 1. Is equal to 180. Then X plus 8. X is equal to 180. Then 9X is equal to 180. Then what is the value of X here? X is equal to 20. We get the value of X, it is 20. Now we can put this value here in equation 1 or either in equation 2 for finding the value of y. So y is equal to 2 into 20, it will be 40. And what is angle C? Angle C is equal to thrice of y, it will be 3 into 40, it will be 120. So again, you can check your answer. We know that angle A is X, that is 20. Angle B is equal to y, that is 40, and we get angle C is equal to 120. We know that the sum of all the angles of a triangle is 180. So 120 plus 40 plus 20, it will be 180. Yes, it means our answer is correct. So this was the question number 5. Now we have only 3 questions here. You will try these questions, or in case of doubt you will ask me in your Zoom class, or if you are not able to join due to the network problem, then you can write in your group. Then I will explain in the next video. Okay, bye.